What's up, space engineers? Are you a rootin' tootin' cowboy ready to get yourself an iron steed? Well, you come to the right place. We got all types of ironclad armored cowboy delivering machines right here at your convenience of credits. That is, if you have a lot of credits, we'll go ahead and sell them to you. But I digress. Let's go ahead and get into the rest of this wonderful video. But I'm probably going to go ahead and do it in character. So, pardon me. There we go. Let's get into it. So the first thing you saw here. Okay, I'll break out of character. I'm sorry. First thing you saw here was the NKE SUV. Yep, simply called the SUV. This was designed for very urban style, I don't even know if that exists in Space Engineers, but very urban style warfare. Very lightly armored. On top we have two auto cannon 30mm chain guns that will, I don't know why I said auto cannon, they will automatically detect enemies for you and their turrets, so there's that. These little ports here is how you get inside. Getting inside, we have two tiny rover cockpit seats, I think they call these. And moving our way to the back is the way the troops kind of get in and out, which is kind of neat. These tiny little fold open doors here, and you can go ahead and look at the seat you want and get into that way. Or if you're feeling really spicy, there actually is a way to go ahead and crouch and get yourself in here. So you could hold a decent amount of people in here, six seated, maybe even eight, but that's a lot of people for a tiny little SUV such as this. And then of course you can close the doors again by hitting the button. Oh, there we go. Oh. Mm-hmm. Alright, well, that one's having a fancy day. There we go. Sometimes it just takes a little bit. The hinges are yeah, they're hinges. Anyway, continuing on. That was the NKE SUV. This is the NKE IFV, which is more of the urban infantry fighting vehicle. This would be used if your target was barricaded into some doors, or possibly if they had armored vehicles of their own. You would want to bring something like this to blast them away. And it's very, very armored as well, just as the other ones. Of course, you have an autocannon on top. That's a real autocannon. That's the actual autocannon that comes vanilla. It's got a little bit of armor plating going on here along the windows along the wheels. The other W word. Yeah, that's right, wrong word. Alright. Moving on way to the back, we have a ramp. A very relaxed ramp that opens slowly. But you can walk onto this pretty easily, and inside we have another four seats. You could probably work six seats in here if you really wanted to cramp it in. Which I don't think I did that for just kind of luxury reasons or whatever, but there you go. That is the infantry fighting vehicle. How you would get into the driver's seat is actually right over here. This little itty bitty crack in between the armored window there. So this cockpit is pretty well armored. There's not a lot that any small arms can do to get into that. Everything will basically get blocked by the glass and everything. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and move on. Now this is the rapid assault vehicle. This would be used if the enemy had maybe, I don't know, air support. There you could use the missiles to shoot out their air support, as well as the 30mm chain guns to give yourself some close range infantry defense. And this also comes with a 30mm chain gun tucked away there for the driver to use if he had to be in a pursuit situation as well. And this again comes with a rear opening, which holds six seats. And also the driver's seat is able to be accessed through the inside there. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot the weapons in here. I never really shoot the weapons in my videos, do I? That's a shame. Let's go ahead and do that. Although I'm sure you've all seen this. But yeah, it shoots six rockets just like that. And then you've got the weapon up front. There you go, that's the rapid assault vehicle. moving on to a rather newer addition to the fleet is the APC Mark VI. I've had a few other APCs, but this one I've actually kind of liked the most. It seems to be the one that is fastest and doesn't tip, which is pretty important. All right, getting into it. We have this pretty well encased driver's seat here. In order to get into it, you'd have to sneak over here, and there you go. There's a way in on each side, but that's how you get into the driver's seat. And this is more meant for like open field, kind of in, you know, battle engagements, and comes with standard twin 30mm chain guns tucked away at the sides there. You might notice that these wheels are a little bit bigger. These are modded 4x4 mirror. I don't know why I said mirrored, but they are. They say mirrored in the description there, but they're 4x4 wheels, and I think they look absolutely awesome. Those are modded wheels, and also they come with the pack is 2x2 wheels, which we'll actually get to see those in a future video of my rover vehicles. Just in case you were doubting how many I had, I have a lot. So many that I'm actually doing 5 at a time in some of these videos. I might be grouping them up and showing them in groups. But anyway, continuing on with the NKE APC Mark VI, we have, again, a folding ramp in the back that leads into here. And in here, you can actually hold up to 8 passengers. And this, but the most important thing about this is it actually comes with a survival kit all piped up, ready to go. And then also something I forgot to mention with all these APCs, besides the SUV, so everything that has a open closed door like this is pressurized. So in case you had to drop these things from space or whatever, you will be able to keep your crew airtight and breathing the entire time. And no oxygen bottles necessary is what I'm trying to say here. And the cool thing about this is it has been integrated with a custom turret, which you may have seen on the top there, so let's go ahead and get into that. In order to get into that, you need to be in the driver's seat, and I'm going to go ahead and, So there we go, we've got a custom, you know, tank turret on top here. Let's go ahead and see what it looks like in third person. Got a little bit of down angle here, so you can, you know, perch yourself a little bit and shoot down into a valley if you had to do that, and an up angle as well, decently, I think about 70 to maybe 75 degrees all the way around, so you can shoot pretty decently far with this. This is meant to be more of like a field command vehicle to where you can respawn your troops as well, keep it hidden in the background and stuff like that, but yeah. That's the APC Mark VI. Maybe let's take it a drive around. We haven't driven any of these. These things are supposed to be drivable, right? What am I doing? Not even driving them for you guys. Let's go ahead and bring up that back ramp there. And this one is kind of fun to drive. Let's see if I can give it a drive here. There we go. Perfect. It's a bit slow to get off the start here, but once it gets going, it's pretty fast. I only like to keep the vehicles around 50 to 60 kilometers or meters a second to prevent from having any terrible accidents. But yeah, the front is pretty easy to see out of. Oh wow, that's actually very loud. Let me turn that down for you guys. I didn't realize how loud that would be in first person. There we go. All right. The front's pretty easy to see out of, so there's no real problem there. If you're somebody who likes to drive in first person, you have a lot of viewing angle to guide this thing through, and it's so wide that, you know, you won't be scared that you'll clip something on the edge by, you know, forcing it through like a tight area or something like that, which I found to be quite nice. Something I overlook in a lot of my vehicles or in a lot of other vehicles I've seen is they're so wide, it's like, you know, that's really great, it can move fast and all, you give it a thruster support, but once it hits something, you've come to a stop, you know what I mean? To where this is really, really, really agile. And I mean, look at that, I'm taking like 90 degree turns. Pretty straight there, I'm not even feeling any roll in the body. Matter of fact, let's go ahead and try and pull a full Yui if we can avoid hitting any of these trees here, yeah. So yeah, there we go, pull another Yui. She's pretty stable, even with that turret on top, so. in case you were wondering, I kind of did a little bit of testing like this with all the vehicles as well. This is just kind of the more extreme case. It's kind of proved to you that they're worth their weight. I suppose they won't roll on you. Go ahead and bring this thing to a full stop there. And she stops pretty fast, too. I mean, I was only going like 40 or something, but, you know. Yeah, that's the APC Mark 6. And moving on to the heavy assault recon tank, I believe. This is the HART for short, HART, heavy assault recon tank. Let me go ahead and look into the info to make sure that that's exactly what this is called. Yes, HART, IFV, another infantry fighting vehicle, but this one has a little bit more of a punch. This is more of like your anti-tank fighting vehicle, comes with a well-protected turret on top. This is, again, those ceramic armor mod plates that I was showing in the last video. They're just super solid. Let me show you. I mean, you could... Oh, damage is turned off. Maybe if I did that. There we go. Well, I mean, a gun's not going to really show too much damage. I mean, these things can take, like, railgun shots, I swear, and only be, like, 10% away from dying. Let's see, where's the auto one? Why can I never find the auto one? Oh, yeah, that's right. It's named the same as everything else. I'm just looking at the tiny symbol. Thanks, Keen. But yeah, you can pop at this all day long if you wanted to. And, yeah, I'm at, what, 4%? So, yeah, that very, very well armor. Another thing that I've noticed about this is we might even give this a try, is at certain times, what I've seen is these assault cannons, if another tank has a bead on you, if it hits you at just the right angle, this shot will come in and freaking deflect off these, barred windows that I have on a hinge down here, and it'll literally deflect up and out. I mean, it might even deflect up and hit the turret, but it will deflect. I've seen it. I swear to God. Maybe I'll have to prove it to you guys here and do some testing. But anyway, moving on through with the HART. It has two seats, one for a driver and one for a turret operator, so you can be driving and shooting this thing at the same time. Again, we have the standard 30mm chain gun for defense. On both sides there, and more ceramic armor for the back panel there to protect the crew, which is housed back here with the ramp. Now, this vehicle does not have a survival kit, but that is okay, because this is more like your, you know, assault and, you know, kind of expendable vehicle almost. You kind of just want to get these things into the enemy's, behind the enemy's back line and, you know, mess them up. Anyway, like I said, all these vehicles with these closing doors should be airtight. I tried to make sure of that. And then we have a button here to close the ramp from the inside. This only seats 4, but with the two driver and co-driver, it is 6. So, yeah, there's that. That is the HART. Let's go ahead and do a little bit of testing to see if we can get an assault shot to bounce, because this is something that I've actually wanted to try for a while now, to see, you know, I've seen it happen before when I was testing it out, but I wasn't recording. So let's go ahead and see when I'm recording if I can get this cannon shot here off of my APC to ricochet off of my heavy assault recon tank there, which almost doesn't even classify as an APC, but whatever, we're gonna go ahead and just say it is, right? Anyway, let's see, this is just about the right angle. Damage is on. Y'all ready for this? Let's see what happens. Hopefully I can, alright, yeah, turn all the stuff that I can. 3, 2, 1. Oof, no, that looks like it went right through, didn't it? Okay. Maybe they patched it. Maybe it was a thing way back, you know, way back before first patch, but... Oh, yeah. No, that's not ricocheting at all. Okay. Wow. Interesting. Interesting, interesting, interesting. Well, I'm glad I proved that right. Or, not right. Proved that wrong. You know what I mean? So, in other ways, I'd be really kind of afraid if everybody just start putting slant stuff... slanted, you know, little itty-bitty small grid windows on their stuff just to deflect cannon shots. But, yeah, okay, well, that's good. At least we don't have to do further testing. We know that that has been busted. But like I said, it was maybe something that did happen, so if any of you guys remember a time when cannon shots used to ricochet off hinges, go ahead and put it in the comments section so maybe I can confirm that I'm not crazy. But anyway, appreciate you guys coming into another NKE video. And have a nice freaking day. Love y'all. Take care. Bye-bye now. You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.